اهدنا الصراط المستقيم.
Guide us to the straight path.
يا صاحبي السجن أأرباب متفرقون خير أم الله الواحد القهار.
وفي سنن الإمام الترمذي حديث عمرو بن شعيب عن أبيه عن جده، وهذا السند حسن، وجده هو عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. The best of دعاء is the دعاء that you make on the day of عرفة. وخير ما قلت أنا والنبيون من قبلي. And the best دعاء that I made and the prophets before me is what? لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. هذا هو الدعاء. يعني سبحان الله، هذه الكلمة تعجب. لا إله إلا الله أعلى شعب الإيمان، أعلى شعب الإيمان. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما في صحيح البخاري حديث أبي هريرة: الإيمان 74 شعبة، وفي رواية 60 شعبة. إيمان faith is 70+ branches. Imagine إيمان to be a tree and it has branches. There are 70+ branches and another wording 60+ branches. The highest branch أعلاها what? لا إله إلا الله. وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق، والحياء شعبة من شعب الإيمان. Because of لا إله إلا الله, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah سبحانه وتعالى created the heavens and the earth. Imagine all this creation is for لا إله إلا الله. وما خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما إلا بالحق. والحق ولا إله إلا الله. We have not created the heavens and the earth and what's in between them but for that truth which is لا إله إلا الله. Because of لا إله إلا الله, Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent the messengers and revealed the books. ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت. وما أرسلنا من قبلك من رسول إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون. Because of لا إله إلا الله, Allah سبحانه وتعالى created جنة and created the hellfire. جنة for those who believed it, implemented it, and hellfire for those who denied it, rejected it, did not implement it. لا إله إلا الله. سبحان الله. أنا يعني I never get tired from narrating that hadith. لا يضرك ذنب مع لا إله إلا الله. يعني sometimes any sin that you make Allah can forgive it, but لا إله إلا الله no. إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will never forgive that you violate لا إله إلا الله. ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. And he will forgive everything else that you may do, anything that you may do, as long as you ask for forgiveness. And what we mean here by shirk, you die as a mushrik, you die in that state. If you are a mushrik, if you're committing shirk, and if you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khalas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the Jews and the Christians, and he said if they come back to Allah, خلاص. لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله والمسيح ابن مريم. Disbelievers are those who say المسيح is Allah. وقال المسيح يا بني إسرائيل اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم. And then أفلا يتوبون إلى الله ويستغفرون. At the end, لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله ثالث ثلاثة. Those who say that Allah is one of three are disbelievers. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after those statements, those two statements in the Quran, he says, if they repent, if they come back to Allah, Allahu ghafurur rahim, Allah will forgive them. We mean by shirk that you die as a mushrik. But even if you commit shirk now, and you say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, and you repent, khalas, in the dunya, but you die as a mushrik. في سنن الإمام الترمذي حديث إلهي, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عبدي, my servant, listen to this, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا. If you come to me with sins, can you imagine this, with sins that fills earth, but with one condition, لا تشرك بي شيئا, not committing shirk. أتيتك بقرابها مغفرة. I will bring you, or I'll meet you with the same quantity forgiveness. ولا أبالي. هذا الحديث that I never get tired from narrating called حديث البطاقة. The حديث of البطاقة. هذا الحديث يعني سبحان الله عرف بهذا الاسم, معروف كده عند يعني is known with the people of حديث بحديث البطاقة. والحديث في مستدرك الحاكم, وقال على شرط مسلم من حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما. Listen to this. يصاح برجل من أمتي على رؤوس الخلائق يوم القيامة. One man from the ummah, one man. This hadith is different to the hadith السبعة. حديث أبي هريرة يقول لك سبعة يظلهم الله في ظل يوم لا ظل إلا ظل. Seven people will be shaded under the throne. إمام عادل, a just imam, a just leader. There are seven people. In hadith Abi Huraira, hadith the seventh, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking about seven kinds, سبع أنواع من الناس. يعني ممكن تحت الإمام العادل could be what, 100,000, إمام عادل, 200,000, million. But this man, listen to this carefully, this man is one man from the ummah. One man only from the ummah. And that is why don't expect yourself to be that man, because it's a very interesting scenario here. It's out of this world. Sure. One man from the ummah, so and so, come to Allah. يصاح برجل من أمتي على رؤوس الخلائق يوم القيامة. He comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيُنْشَرُ لَهُ تِسْعَةٌ وَتِسْعُونَ سِجِلًّا كُلُّ سِجِلٍ مِثْلُ مَدِّ الْبَصَرِ. He will have 99 books of sins. Books. Sins. 99 books. This is not the amazing piece. You know what the amazing piece? If you unfold one of these books, it will reach as far as his eyesight reaches. طب imagine, يعني هذا الرجل ما شغل نفسه غير بالذنوب. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him, هل ظلمك كتبتي? Did they record my scribes, my angels, my recording angels? Did they write something that you did not do? قَالَ لَا يَا رَبِّ. I said, no, Allah. I did all of this. Do you want to refute any of this? Do you have a problem with anything that is recorded? لَا يَا رَبِّ. Everything is in there. then subhanallah he will be leaving thinking that he's about to be thrown in the hellfire. فقل عبدي, my servant, come back. إن لك عندي بطاقة. There is a card. وإنه لا يظلم عندي اليوم أحد. And today there is no injustice. فيقول أي رب, he will say, يا رب, وما تفعل هذه البطاقة أمام هذه السجلات. What this card will do in the scale in front of all these books. فقال عبدي احضر وزنك. Stay until you see your scale. فتوضع هذه البطاقة. This card will be placed in one pan of the scale. And the 99 books of evil, sins, of sinning, will be placed in the other pan of the scale. فترجح بهن البطاقة. That again, that card will outweigh all these 99 books. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, وَلَا يَرْجَحُ بِاسْمِ اللَّهِ شَيْءٍ. What is written in this bitaqa, brothers and sisters, in Islam? لا إله إلا الله. This is somebody who understood this word. But he was weak. He got engaged in sins. But again, I want to warn you, this is what? One man. But it really also sends a message to us that never judge a Muslim. Never judge a Muslim. Here is somebody who never pass a judgment over a Muslim. Oh, you're going to the hellfire, you're done because he's sinning. No, don't do this. يعني في سنن الإمام الترمذي, two brothers. One of them is righteous, the other one is not righteous. Off and on. Sins, repents, sins, repents, sins, repents. Hijras. The righteous person used to go on and live on the top of the hill, and he used to come down and visit his brother. So when he came down, he found his brother sinning. فقال له, he said to him, والله لن يغفر الله لك. By Allah, Allah will not forgive you. فسمعه ربه وهو السميع. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet at the time, and he said, من هذا الذي يتأله علي؟ Who is taking my place? Who is taking my position? Who is taking an oath on me? This is my call. It is not anybody's call. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to the Prophet, أخبرهو, tell that person that because of what you said, I have forgiven your sinning brother and all your righteous deeds that you done in the past are in vain. Start working over now. غفرت له وأحبطت عملك. Because of the statement that you made. That person of Hadith al-Bitaqa, subhanAllah, one of the rawat هذا الحديث اسمه حمزة الكناني. يعني the 4th century after Hijra. 357 years after the Hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went to Egypt and he narrated this hadith في مسجد عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنه. In مسجد عمرو بن العاص, one of the people who heard this hadith صعق, he died.